Okay, hi there. I'm Jody from Fuse FM, and I'm joined by the lovely Zach and Nathan from Hippocampus. Hi, guys.
Hi.
So, firstly, I wanted to discuss this year. It's been a big year for you guys. You've managed to release an album and an EP. Why did you decide to do two, or was it an active decision?
The album was definitely, like, baked for a very long time. So, like, let's release an album. And then, you know, this summer we were just like playing a bunch of festivals, and the song Baseball, like a lot of fans had like caught wind of that and they wanted it to be released, but it never made the album. So it's like we had a couple of songs just left over from the album that we wanted to take another pass at, and the EP kind of came out of that.
Ooh. And what really intrigued me is the front cover of Landmark is your old practice room.
Right.
And what was that meant to represent, something like, why did you decide on that picture?
That's like, we all used to practice at my house, like in the basement, and that was the room. And I think we wanted to use that sort of like slightly disconnected from reality, because like we didn't want to use the actual room as like a picture or anything, but like that's where all the songs were written.
Yeah.
And that's where we could, we like to just consider that home base, like after, you know, a lot of touring and like our first sort of experience on the road, we always come back home and find the place where we could like still be ourselves. So like representing that batch of songs with that album cover sort of made sense to us.
Nice. And so I've been a fan for quite a long time. I played Suicide Saturday on like one of my first ever radio shows in like 2015.
Nice.
And so I was wondering from then, because that's quite different to your stuff now, how do you think, what has like affected your style change, or how do you think you've changed as a band or individuals?
I think meeting a lot of people who are in this industry as well, people who are doing the same thing as we are in different ways, and talking to them about how they do things, just sharing and all of this together, that's kind of affected the way we look at it, at least personally. And
just learning.
Yeah.
You know, like going around and just like you know, meeting people. You know, working with different producers with the album we did, it was with BJ Britton, and he helped a lot. We've changed as people too, our tastes have changed a lot.
Yeah.
It's really just
the reasons why we listen to music in the first place.
Yeah, everything's changed.
But
we still have, you know, the crutches that we rely on musically, so I think those are always going to be there.
Yeah. It seems like, again, everything in between shows and music seems to, like, affect the way we think about it more so than, you know, it's like this very small percentage of like actually playing and writing and performing that kind of makes it all up, and then everything else is just like, there's like 22 other hours in the day that we're not
doing that.
So I mean, like, all the hard drugs too.
All the
smack, meth, crack, you know, it's just...
Get the student radio.
Yes.
My butt.
Are there any new upcoming bands or artists that you particularly like the look of, think they're going to be the next big thing?
Holy shit.
A
lot of our friends are in bands, and we're just like uber fans of theirs. Happy Children is one of them.
I think DiCarlo Jackson plays trumpet with us back in the States, and that dude is just like so talented.
Mega talent. Yeah.
He should really be... We're lucky to have him for as long as we have. He should go out and do something else.
We have friends in a band called Remo Drive, and they're coming up pretty quick. We're touring with a band called Sure Sure in the States, and they're talents. Other than that, there's like Little Comets. I mean,
they're good.
They've been around
they're
forever,
really
and I love them.
So tonight, Manchester, it's sold out, which means Manchester loves you guys. But we're wondering, how much do you love Manchester?
A lot.
We've got a little game. So, I've got a few words that are classic Mancunian words.
Wow.
And because you're American, I'm thinking you're going to have no idea what they mean. And so let's see how it goes.
Yeah.
So if you get it wrong, I'll tell you the real meaning. If you get it right, we'll be impressed.
Gotcha.
So we're going to start with an easy one.
Yeah.
Brew.
Beer?
Beer.
No, oh my God.
Cry. Sip.
Tea.
Oh, okay.
Tea.
I'm sorry.
Zoe's doing some crazy actions behind camera. Okay, brew is tea.
Okay, well, that makes sense.
Yeah.
In the States, it's beer.
Okay. Sulfids. Sulfids.
Can you use an essence?
S-O-L-F-I-D.
Oh, go and pull up your sulfids.
Pants?
Trousers.
Socks. Oh,
socks.
Sulfids.
Sulfids are socks in Manchester.
Interesting.
Yeah.
0 out of 3.
Well, that could be like 0.5 kind of point.
One too many syllables.
And Scran.
Scran. The abbreviation for the town that the office took place in. Scranton.
Oh, Scran. Scran, Pennsylvania.
Scran. Change. Money.
Fight?
Fight.
Scran.
No, that would be a good one, but no, Scran is food.
Oh.
So let's go get some Scran. I'm starving.
What's up with you guys? Why are you doing this?
Okay, two more.
Okay.
You got 0 of 4. Yeah. They're doing well. I really thought you'd get through. I thought I was going easy on you with that one. Okay. Mint. If something's mint.
That's cool.
It's fresh.
Ah. Oh.
That's
1 point.
Okay. That's
mint rare.
And finally, gaff.
It's a house.
Yes.
I knew that one.
Well done. I didn't think you'd get that one.
I didn't either.
I stared into space and it came
to me. Well done.
Space over there.
2 out of 6.
That's a fail. That's a failing grade. Just use all those words in one sentence tonight on stage.
Everyone
we should write one.
Yeah.
Gonna drink some brew at the gaff.
And then get my
pull up
car fennelled.
Fettled. And then pull up our scaffolds.
Right, fully transformed Mancunians. Right here. Thank you so much for having us at the campus. It was lovely to meet you.
Lovely to meet you too. Thanks for having us.
And good luck with your show tonight.
Thank you.
Thank you.
And the rest of your tour.
Thank you.
Yeah.